Hello, everyone. My name is Sika Gadzanku, and I'm a researcher at the National Renewable Energy Laboratory. This is the first presentation in the Enhanced Load Modeling and Forecasting online course. And in this presentation, I'll be providing an introduction to load modeling and demand forecasting in Southeast Asia. Mainly, I will be touching on the ongoing power sector transformation in Southeast Asia and how that requires kind of a more enhanced approach to long-term load modeling and forecasting, and then look ahead to the rest of the presentations in this course. So the Asian, specifically the Southeast Asian energy sector, is rapidly kind of transforming with exceptional economic growth and population growth, and this is driving energy demand. And with this increase in energy demand, there is a drive to ensure reliable, secure, safe, and affordable energy supply is available to kind of all populations across the various countries in the region. And at the same time, clean energy costs have become more more competitive with other generation technologies due to unprecedented technological advances, falling capital generation costs, and changes to utility business models. And so more and more countries and governments are exploring opportunities to harness high quality, cost-effective renewable energy resources to meet their clean energy goals and just their larger kind of economic development goals. And with this comes the need for new data tools, analyses, capabilities, and approaches to inform energy sector decision making. And within this need is the specific need for enhanced approaches to modeling and forecasting long-term electricity demand. So now I'm going to kind of touch on three major trends we've seen that have really kind of require an enhanced approach to load modeling and forecasting. First is that driven by urbanization, rising incomes, economic growth, and population growth, electricity demand in the region has grown tremendously and is projected to double in the next 20 years, as seen in the figure to your right. And additionally, there is set to be specific tremendous growth in residential and industrial load. As we can see in this figure, we see that demand for buildings and if industry is set to grow by a lot over the next 20 years. And then the second trend we're seeing is that looking at specific sectors, there is a lot of change and growth in residential electricity demand. And this is largely due to rising incomes. And we see that electricity used for buildings is projected to see the largest growth across all sectors. And majority of this growth is driven by two end uses: cooling, largely from the increased use of air conditioners, and then the increased use of appliances. So if we look up to the figure to our right, we see that over the next 20 years, there's going to be a lot of projected growth in cooling and appliance use. And then the final trend that we're seeing is that, so there have been changes on the demand side, as we've seen with the first two trends, but there's also been a lot of change on the supply side of the power sector. We see that the energy electricity generation mix is changing as specifically more renewables come online. So with wind and solar generation set to play a large role in meeting increased electricity demand, there is a need to adapt the power system, specifically adapt power system operation and planning methods to account for the variability of these resources. As you can see in the figure to your right, this figure, which summarizes kind of the power generation mix, which summarizes projections of the power generation mix over the next 20 years, we see that wind and solar and other renewables are projected to meet over a third of the kind of electricity demand by 2040. And we know that in some countries in the region, it already meets that and is set to meet an even larger percentage of electricity demand. So as I said, these three major trends: increase electricity demand, increased shares of renewables, and evolving electricity end uses kind of requires changes to power system planning and operation methods. And so all kind of these trends are showing us that the energy future will require a flexible grid. And what this the energy future in Southeast Asia will require a flexible grid. And what this means is that there is a need to adapt planning approaches to incorporate flexibility in them. As we can see in the figure to the right, the figure kind of in orange are the kind of existing approaches to planning, and in green are some of the ways that we can incorporate flexibility into our planning approaches. And so when we're thinking about kind of load modeling and forecasting, part of this shift in planning approaches means updating load modeling methods to accurately assess changing electricity demand while accounting for the variability of wind and solar resources. And it also means updating long-range demand forecasting to better account for future electricity demand. And what does this mean? This means that, you know, we need to have better long-term demand forecasting models that account for demographic changes, population changes, that are more have more detailed economic models and projections. Because having just more detailed models will allow us to better predict future electricity demand. And we know in the region there's increasing interest or use of advanced energy systems such as electric vehicles and energy storage. And all of these future changes in the energy future in the region just require just more enhanced approaches to power system planning and operations. So looking ahead in this course, what we're trying to do is really provide an introduction to the various enhanced load modeling and demand forecasting approaches. But first, we want to really set a strong foundation. So the rest of the presentations over the next 7 weeks of this course will touch on why modeling and forecasting is important in a system with high levels of variable renewable energy. We will touch on some common load modeling and forecasting approaches, so really touching on existing load modeling and forecasting approaches. And then we'll start to kind of look at enhanced approaches by first outlining some of the differences between top-down and bottom-up load modeling and forecasting, and then provide a few case studies of some emerging state-of-the-art bottom-up load modeling and forecasting approaches for the different sectors that we kind of think about. So whether it's commercial buildings, residential buildings, kind of industry, transportation, how or what are some of the enhanced approaches that are being used to model load and forecast demand. And then we'll also look at the role of demand side management and energy efficiency in load modeling and forecasting. And finally, we will kind of conclude with how do we connect all of this excellent load modeling and forecasting work that is happening and these enhanced approaches to policy and implementation. So a visual of this is that in module one, we'll kind of provide an introductory or an introduction to the course, and then provide an overview of load modeling and forecasting approaches generally. And then in module two, we'll then dive into specific sectoral focuses. So we'll look at kind of load modeling and forecasting approaches for residential and commercial building load, and then also look at load modeling and forecasting approaches for industrial and transportation loads. And then module three, we will conclude with a look at demand side management and energy efficiency. And then the final unit of the course will look at scenario-based thinking and connecting load models and planning to policy and implementation. And then in the final live discussion session, we will outline next steps. So whether you're coming from a utility, the regulatory commission, or you're part of a policy planning unit in a government agency, what are some concrete next steps you can take to make sure to help you apply kind of all the knowledge you've accrued over the course of this, over the course in your work. Great. That is the end of my presentation. This was just meant as an introduction to the course. Please contact myself, sika.gadzanku@nrel.gov, if you have any specific questions about the course content. And contact isabel.mccann@nrel.gov with any kind of technical questions. If you have questions about Litmos or WebEx training, please reach out to her. Thank you.